Hello everyone. Today I, Shivang Joshi, co-founder of Law Community, brings another great personality, Mr. Keshav Garg. He has been practicing before Supreme Court of India, Delhi High Court, and in front of NCLT, NGT, DRT, CDRF, CAT, and various other tribunals. We will interact with sir to know more about his journey. Hello sir, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Fine sir. Welcome to Law Community. And my first question is, what inspired you to pursue law as a career? And can you share your experience at law school with us?
Yeah, sure. To be honest, the inspiration came from the family circumstances. Okay. The need to fight against the injustice in the society inspired me to opt law as my career. Mostly in our family, all are doing business, and I'm the first lawyer in my entire family. So it is a law faculty, Delhi University, from where I had cracked the entrance and pursued my law. Initially, it took a lot to learn and understand the thing at a law school, but gradually, my keen interest and dedication changed the thing for me. It is very important to mention here that law is nothing but the logic itself. You just have to become more logical to understand the deep knowledge in legal profession or studies. I feel so proud that I have studied law from one of the renowned law school of India. From our respected dean to faculty teachers, all were available for me to resolve my doubts. The complete environment of my law school was very healthy and positive. So, you know, that's the way I pursue my career in law, and, you know, my experience is very good in my faculty of law, Delhi University. It was a great exposure, I must say.
Okay, sir. So my next question is, after graduation, how did you pursue your career in law, and what challenges did you face in the nascent stage of your career?
Yeah. To be honest, from the day one, I wanted to do something into the legal field. Okay. But after my graduation, initially, I have to look after my family's pharma business, as at that time, my father was suffering from colon cancer. Okay. So besides looking after the family business, I have completed my master's in political science. As my father starts improving, I had started preparing for the law entrance examination. Interestingly, I had filed only law faculty Delhi University entrance form, and gave my 100% for about 5 to 6 months to get selected. I still remember that those 5 to 6 months were very crucial time of my life. And I used to study to the library. I used to study in the library of the campus law center, law faculty itself, for about 10 to 12 hours a day. So, you know, it's a bit challenging time for me. The key is that you need to do, the key is very simple, is there. Like, you need to do extra work and dedication, you know, extra hard work and dedication if you want to achieve your dream in life. Okay. It was a remarkable day, and I felt so motivated when I got the desired results from my hard work.
Okay, sir. So, sir, my next question is, you have founded the organization called Vakil 24/7. What was your idea behind founding such an organization?
Yeah, that's a very good question. And before answering this question, I want to share my secret of spiritual experience, okay, which I got by joining Brahma Kumari's Center for Raj Yoga Meditation. It is correct that I have learned law and got my legal degree from my law school, but the hunger to fight for justice for others came from the meditation itself. By following the Raj Yoga meditation, I become more soul conscious, powerful, and dedicated from the inner mind. Now, by optimizing good ideas and creativity, I'm trying to help those who have suffered a lot while getting the prolonged justice. To be very honest with you, sir, I understand so early that my profession is among those professions in which I can help immensely to the public at large. People nowadays feel very conscious and scared from the lawyers. The tendency of some professionals is also not good towards their client in respect to the consultation, their fees, and time taken in disposal of their respective cases. So the idea behind Vakil 24/7 is simple, that is to help those who need you the most. The motive behind Vakil 24/7 is to provide absolute and bona fide solutions across 24/7. So my main objective is to provide genuine consultation as well as speedy justice to the public at large. For me and my firm, the money part comes at secondary level, sir. Okay. As well as we don't charge for consultation fees who are not able to pay for it. I personally, as a founder of Vakil 24/7, give my best shot to resolve my client disputes by mutual settlements and agreements. It might be by doing out of court settlements or in court settlements. Sir, by God's grace and wisdom, we are achieving our goal towards winning the faith and confidence of the people towards our legal fraternity, who were somehow not satisfied with the ongoing legal dominance and culture.
Okay, sir. So my next question is, you have worked also as a paralegal volunteer for DSLSA. Can you share your thoughts and experience regarding the same?
Yeah, DSLSA, you know, it is a great organization, I must say, no? You know, who are meant for helping the large group of people at a ground level. My experience with them was extraordinary. Apart from taking part in their different mass awareness programs, I had also done 14-day internship program with them. They initially helped me to understand the ground reality and grievances of people and taught me the different procedures to resolve the same. There, I also learned about the practical functioning of different courts, tribunal, forums, and NGOs. I must say that DSLSA is doing a remarkable and outstanding job in helping the societies at large. So, yeah, DSLSA, you know, is a great organization.
So my next question is, what significant changes would you like to see, especially in the field of litigation, which can improve the workings in the court?
First of all, you know, I'm not a big critic who just want to change everything, to be very honest. Although, on the other hand, there is always a room for a change and for the growing demand of need for justice. We can always use more technology in some of the areas, like, for example, we can fully digitalize arrangement can be done in servicing of summons and court notices, okay, and in filing and obtaining certified copies at a pan-India level, so that anyone can, you know, apply for a certified copy from their house, from their home, or any advocate can, you know, apply it without visiting to the physical, without visiting to their office or for their window, and can apply it and obtain it online. Okay, and while discussing about the summons and court notices, it is seen very often that there are a lot of time is, you know, there are a lot of time and money is wasting in giving summons and notices to the via speed post and via different modes of communication. Okay, and still there are 6 months time left, passed away, and 3 months times are passed away, and there is no notice served. So there should be a proper mechanism while we can servicing the summons and a court notices. Okay. Nowadays, we have already seen that services like e-filing of court cases and e-hearing has been initiated by the court. And I personally think this has a very positive change for delivering the speedy and time-bound justice. More emphasis should be given. Okay. On alternative dispute resolution, sir. Okay,
sir. So, sir, my next question is, what changes do you see in the legal sector post-COVID-19?
Yeah, the changes are already being seen, actually, as the court adopted e-platforms, you know, to facilitate the proper functioning of law and order. You know, nowadays we can see it. Some statutes like IBC has already suspended their core operations, by which now the new case of insolvency and bankruptcy could not be entertained against a defaulter. Okay, there are some changes going on. Also, the news is going on like there are some laws, there are some petty criminal offenses, and there are some check bounce cases, check bounce laws are going to amend soon to safeguard the interest of the businessmen or safeguard the interest of the public. Okay, and minimize the burden over the judiciary. Okay, and the legal sector as a whole, sir, will take its own time to run smoothly and profoundly, because this is a major outbreak going on, COVID-19. So I'm not saying that it will start immediately. Our legal sector will start immediately. It will take its own time, and once the things are on pace, it will gain the speed by their own.
What advice or suggestion would you like to give to the professionals who have just started their career in law, or to the law students who are still studying?
In short and precise, the key is to have the proper patience and to make day-to-day small targets and achievements. There are, sir, no shortcuts in this profession. It needs proper investment of time, positive energy and attitude. The sole motive of a new or an old professional should not be involved in any money-making practices or in short-term benefits. The only thing which need to be focused is to learn the practical knowledge of law as much as possible and to provide best possible bona fide solutions and practical solutions to client and the one who needs it the most.
Okay, sir. Last but not the least, how can an organization like law community prove beneficial to the legal fraternity, and what new avenues are expected by the legal professionals such as yourself?
Sir, in regards with the law community, you guys are doing a very good job. I'm also personally subscriber of your law community platform. Okay, and I got a regular legal updates by which one can make ourselves up to date with the latest judgments, orders. It helps both the new as well as old legal professionals to keep learning new legal propositions, terms, guidelines, okay, and much more. So I must say that you guys are doing a great job, and I also come to know that now you are going to launch your e-magazine, okay, and a great exposure is going to be given to the new lawyers as well as the old professionals, so that they can come together at your platform and learn different things and they can communicate. So it will be good. It will be great exposure to all the legal sector, after joining to such a good community.
Thank you very much, sir, for having such an amazing interaction with us. It will definitely gonna benefit a lot of young minds. We are delighted to have you time with us at Law Community, and is grateful for the same. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.